I grew up here in Portland. As a child, we all love Indiana Jones, but it was actually really in high school when I was able to take an anthropology class, and it really piqued my interest. And then in community college, I started taking archaeology classes. The coast is not forgiving to the artifacts that we're finding. They're often broken up, small chunks of what we would find.
Even though we've got only fragments, they can really tell us where they were made, when, and even who for. The first thing you notice about these blue-colored designs is that they are Chinese. So why are Chinese porcelains being brought to Oregon? We found the sherds were from large plates and cups, matching the European desire for large meals in mugs of hot chocolate.
This is likely a cup. We don't really know what the groove foot rim was meant to be or what the purpose of it is, but apparently it was a very big thing with the European market at the time. Using all this data together, we have come to a mean date of 1690.
And what's intriguing is that it's 120 years before any Europeans arrived in Oregon.
That beach on that side, there's a lot of porcelain that seems to be right.
So basically what you're seeing is material like directly on the opposite side of where we currently are?
Yeah. Yeah.
And
yeah,
you've recovered some porcelain just north of here?
Lots of it.
Yeah. So, you know, you go here to there to there, it kind of lines up, you know?
This is an underwater environment known by local fishermen as a place where they've hung nets. And that's always a great indication of a place that could be parts of a shipwreck.
Are we clear?
That's perfect, okay.
We're looking at the data as it's being collected, and nothing was obviously sticking out.
I should have had more coffee this morning.
And suddenly we saw this one area where there was this linear feature. It looked almost like the spines of the back of a stegosaurus.
There's definitely something out here. We're starting to pick up already some linear features in an otherwise sandy environment, you know, that doesn't really look like rock. Oh, here, already, here we're starting to pick up a few more of those. Yeah, it is. 4 or 5 meters long, something like that, and another.
Maybe that's the broken mast. Yeah. Oh, look, it's got a hollow shadow in the middle.
There's a whole notch out in this. This is really, yeah, you probably see it in the, whoa. Look at that. Look at it up here in the point.
Oh, man, look at the bow. You can see the stern, it almost looks like a bow and a stern.
Sometimes X marks the spot.
Mm-hmm.
Could that be the beeswax?
It could be.